If you don't have a drone or a helicopter, you can get some really good pseudo aerials just by standing on the shore and looking down. In fact, whether it's in the forest, might be on the pavement, but here at the beach, I'm looking for a pattern shot with lots of shells and rocks, little bits of seaweed, and then later on in post-production, I'm going to take them back and I'm going to play with their values. I'm going to play with how light, how dark they are, and the colour of the image, just to create a wonderful abstract pattern, something that could look really good up on a wall. Normally, I'd probably use a tripod to make sure that everything is tack sharp, but if you ramp your ISO up a little bit, in other words, if you increase your ISO a little bit, so it's a bit higher, you can handhold very satisfactorily. And of course, a lot of cameras these days, they've got image stabilization. One of the things to think about when you're shooting like this is that you're quite close to your subject. And the closer to your subject, the shallower the depth of field. So while I could use a wider aperture like f2.8, f4, I'm using f8, because that's going to give me a little bit more depth of field, a little bit more sharpness on my subject, so that when people look at my photo, the whole of the shell looks nice and sharp. The other thing that I'm doing is I'm pointing the camera directly down. So it's like a plan photograph, like an architect's drawing of a house or a building or something like that. It's looking straight down. And I think that gives it a more of an abstract feeling. You can put it at a bit of an angle, but as soon as you bring in the rest of the scene or the horizon or the clouds, then suddenly you've just got a low angle photograph. This way, you've got more of a pattern shot, more of an abstract.
So my idea behind these photos is to create a simple composition, a plan view looking straight down on top, and then just having this massive detail around the subject. And I've greatly simplified it with this particular composition. I just have a single shell, and it really stands out against the other little rocks and shells on the beach there. So it's a simpler one to demonstrate what I'm trying to do. And as you can see, it's all about colour and contrast. The colour of the background, the contrast in the background is very subdued. It's quite blue in colour. In comparison, the shell is warm and orange, and it's quite sharp and contrasty. So it stands out. So when a viewer looks at this photograph, there's no doubt what the subject is. So let's just have a little look at the starting point. The image is captured is quite considerably duller and darker. So it's all a matter of using, in this case, Lightroom to re-engineer the photograph, to reinterpret it, to use our imagination to create something a little different. So let's go exploring in Lightroom. I'm going to start off by coming up to my light panel, and let's just look at the image. If we grab the exposure slider and we move it left and right, you can see that very quickly we can adjust the image. So rather, although here as our starting point it's a little bit on the dull side, we can lighten it up, and that's quite easily achieved. However, in doing so, notice how the shell doesn't stand out from the rest of the subject. The rest of the subject has got just as much contrast. So knowing that I'm going to adjust the shell on its own later on, what I want to do is reduce the contrast in the background. So let's grab the contrast slider, and we're just going to move that. I'm moving it more or less all the way down. And you can see that as I do that, how it's really dropping the contrast. And that makes a background that is more neutral, more muted, something against which the shell can really stand out. Now, let's look at the color, and we'll just come down here, and we've got our colour here, our temperature, it's as shot to start with, but I'm going to grab the temp, and I'm just going to move the temperature slider to the left, and you can see that makes it blue. If I go all the way, whoa, that's a little bit too blue, but we just move it a little bit further to the left, and yes, my shell's going blue, but we'll come back to that later on. I'm just looking at the background. Now, if we go back, if we're thinking back to the first shot, I could perhaps make that background a little bit more muted, and we'll see that some of the dark stones are a little bit too strong, so let's slide back up. And we've got a little slider here called blacks. If we grab the black slider and move it to the left, well, that's not doing it. But if we move it to the right, we're lightening up those blacks. Notice how it's not affecting the highlights too much. We don't want to lighten up the highlights too much because, you know, if we do that, we're losing detail with the highlight slider, or certainly with the whites. You know, that's not a good look. But with the blacks, on this occasion, we can just lighten them up a little bit. And we could even come back down to our color mixer and pick our blues, and we could possibly just, you know, desaturate those down a little bit as well. So we've got a cool look, and that's, you know, there are a number of different interpretations we could have. Let's assume that we're happy with the way the background looks. Okay, so let's go to work on that shell. And we're just going to come down here to our adjustment brush icon and click on that. We've got the brush there, nice and simple, and the size and the feather. Well, the size is going to be relatively small because I need to paint in the edge of the shell, although some people might be tempted to have a hard edge so they can precisely follow the edge of the shell. I generally use a soft edge, and I don't mind there being a little bit of spill, a little bit of a feather over the edge. So we're just going to paint over there, and I've gone out there a little bit, outside the edges a little bit. That's okay. We'll come back and look at that later on. Now, let's come along, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to change the color a little bit. And in Lightroom, I grab the temp, and I'm going to go the other way. So I'm just going, if I go all the way, look at the color that I'm bringing in. That's just with the temp. And that was very quick. You'll notice too that although my mask isn't particularly precise, you can see when I hold my cursor over the little blue circle there, you can see the mask in red, and it does spill out over the sides, but it's not too bad. Let's now just give it a little bit more emphasis, so we might increase the contrast a bit. You see how that contrast is bringing it up? And then we could even come down and try something like clarity. And clarity might also just give it a little bit more presence. And so that's looking quite nice. Maybe a little bit of color saturation. I'm certainly one who likes a bit of color. Adding it in a little bit more, and we're more or less there. And we can fiddle around with this backwards and forwards. If we thought now the background could be adjusted, we then just come back to our overall settings, and we could look at our highlights, for instance. We could darken those down a little bit. We can even take the exposure down a little bit. So we can adjust the image in many, many different ways. But it's all starting with that idea of capture followed by post-production, and this sort of mini aerial where we're taking our camera, and instead of being in a drone or a helicopter, we're just pointing it straight down and seeing what we can find.